Well, Keith, the Lord has been doing some major things in your life, heaps of blessing. Amen? Tell us about it.
Yeah, so the Lord is so good. Back in December of last year, after the Lord had told me he wanted me to come down here, I was driving to work, and he was like, son, I was praying, like, Lord, do you want me to fly down or do you want me to drive down here? And he was like, you're going to fly down, you're going to drive back. I'm like, okay, I don't know how that's going to work out. But I'm like, all right. So I bought a plane ticket to fly down here. I had nothing. I only had a few $100s. The Lord provided a place to stay, job, everything. And so I gave my car to my brother last year. I was like, you can have it. I don't want it anymore. You know what I'm saying? That car is like for my old lifestyle and everything like that, and I didn't change and everything, so you can have that. But I had bought a motorbike on a Facebook market from this lady. And the reason I had bought the bike from her is because I had seen in her bio, it said she believes in God and everything like that. And I was like, all right, I just felt at peace about it. So she comes to bring me the bike because I needed a new bike to get to work. I work like 5 miles from my house and I wasn't paying for Ubers and walking. I definitely wasn't doing that. So she came and brought me the bike. And as soon as I come, I'm like, you know Jesus? She's like, yeah, I know Jesus and everything. So we were talking about the Lord, having a good conversation. Now, the bike was good for like the first 3 weeks. After that, like the tires start popping, and the tire popped about 7 different times, like no lie. And every single time she's been faithful, she's then came and fixed the tire for me. And I remember one time I was riding home and the motor stopped working. And I was like on South Broadway Street over there. And I was like, God, you told me I was gonna fly down here, I was gonna drive back, and you told me to seek first your kingdom and all its righteousness. And that's what I've been doing. I've been winning souls, I've been watching people get healed, I've been setting the captives free, all types of stuff, you know? And the Bible says, let us not grow weary in doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. So I've been standing on that. I'm like, God, you said this, and I'm going to keep doing what you told me to do. And this week during healing school, she came to my tire pop. She came to fix a tire on Tuesday. I went to work that night. I rode home. I woke up the next day with another flat tire. I'm like, you got to be kidding me. So I was sitting in healing school on Wednesday. And she's like, for the past week, I've been feeling like the Lord has been telling me to buy you a car. Now mind you, for that whole week, I've been praying, Lord, let someone who has an ear hear my prayer. Open her heart to receive it, because the Bible says, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. So I was like, give someone an ear to hear and bless me, Lord. And and I just thought about it, and I was like, Lord, I don't know how. I'm like, Lord, you told me I was going to fly down here, I was going to drive back and everything. And I've been feeling like, Lord, when is it going to happen? You know, because I'm going back to New York next month. So I'm like, God, it has to get to, like, do this kind of soon. You know what I'm saying? And but I, like I said, I've been being obedient. Anyways, I was sitting in healing school on Wednesday. She texts me. She's like, you ready to go get your car? I'm like, yeah. So I walked out of healing school, walked in the bathroom, started jumping around, did a little praise. You know what I'm saying? And I came back. Heaps. It's been heaps and heaps and heaps. And I was believing God for money to drive back to Rochester, too. And I was like, I'm going to sow a seed. And I ended up getting blessed with $200 like 2 days later as well. So God is so good.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.